Week 2 of the CrossFit Open is here, and was met by the community with a resounding, "Ugh!" With literally hundreds of reps of deadlifts and burpees to do, CrossFitters are writing goodbye letters to their lower backs and lactic acid systems. And this scenario is eerily familiar. Last year, 21.1 had wall walks, and 21.2 had burpees. In fact, here's a clip of my commentary from last year.
How many times did you do 21.1 last week? Did you redo it? Did you do it a third time? Well, get ready to do it a fourth time, losers. Oh, you thought you were done laying on the floor? Nope. Get back down into that pool of your own sweat and literally reflect on your life choices that brought you to this point.
So it looks like history is repeating itself, not only in world wars, but also in the CrossFit Open. With this year's first event involving pushing off the floor and pulling during dumbbell snatches, week 2 has more pushing off the floor and pulling during deadlifts. Despite these overlaps, the workouts did feel different for me. Both were very Metcon intensive, but week 1 felt more like cardiac and breathing limitations, whereas week 2 felt a lot more lactic with some of that burning fatigue. So with that in mind, my first piece of advice is that you want to get a full warm-up. Before you start the workout, you need to give your body a taste of that lactic acid at the pace you're going to be moving at during the workout. This could look like a few sets and or a few rounds of anywhere from 4 to 8 reps of each movement. During this, and here's the second tip, you gotta nail your footwork. There's so many transitions in this workout that you might find yourself jumping over the bar, finishing a set of burpees, and then realizing, oh wait, I have to deadlift again? Yeah, you gotta deadlift again, like 100 times. So you wanna have an entry and re-entry plan for each set of deadlifts so that you're not wandering around too far from the bar and losing out on transition time. Everyone's pacing plan is gonna be different, but the movement patterns are fairly universal, so that's my third piece of advice. At the start of your warm-up, nail down this hip hinge movement pattern. I like single leg Romanian deadlifts, banded good mornings, and Russian kettlebell swings, don't tell the Ukraine, to prime my hips for smooth cycling of the barbell. Now let's dive into the numbers of this workout with a full-on breakdown from our special correspondent. At this point, the numerology involved here is undeniable. Workout 22.2. The year is 2022. It's the second week of the Open. There are 2 movements in the workout for a total of 200 reps. The deadlift weight is 225 pounds. So what does this mean? Well, the symbol for 2 is a peace sign. It also makes a V for Vladimir. Clearly, this is a message calling for a cease to European conflict. And look how many dashes are in the rep scheme. This is obviously Morse code, relaying tactical information. Think about it. Supposedly, Dave Castro wrote these workouts. Dave was a Navy SEAL, so maybe this symbol is a peace out sign from Castro as he's going dark on a mission to take out Putin and end World War III. This has been hashtag HQAnon. I can't wait to see the Netflix original about that. We do have one more correspondent to check in with, but before we do, this video was brought to you by Virus International. Whether you like it or not, for better or for worse, this workout is going to give you a juicy booty. If you're good at CrossFit, you'll use your glutes and get a sweet rump pump. Or if you're bad at CrossFit, you'll be crapping yourself and sweating bullets. Either way, juicy booty. But there is a third way, and that's Virus International. Virus has the best apparel and compression gear for people who train hard. The clothes fit just right to show off your hams and gams and yams, and they use performance fabrics that are moisture wicking and anti-odor. You know, for the booty juice. Use code Parker through my affiliate link to get yourself a sweet deal and support the channel. Speaking of nice butts, lyrical correspondent, do you have any thoughts? Maybe on the live open announcement? Perhaps some comments on the female athletes that we could cancel you for and never have to see you again? What? Nah, man, nah, mean. Function and good form are the only things that interest me. Props to Lawson Rep in Canada and Horvashi from Hungary. Vlad should take notes on international diplomacy. This workout might be hard, but not as bad as fighting World War III. Count 100 burpees, someone give me a lobotomy. Do 100 deadlifts, gonna need a bacchiotomy. But if I'm being honest, this shit really doesn't bother me. I got a juicy booty and my hips got that mobility. If you vibe with this, make sure you like, comment, and follow, please.